Oh, hey, didn't see you there. Hey guys, I'm Khadroth. Today I'm going to be talking to you guys about the caster node at Galemas, aka NA's Christmas this year in 2021. This is going to be our third node, just behind the Berserker node and before the Saber node. So this is going to be a really nice node for people in a lot of regards. Should have a whole lot of easy options. People tend to have really nice riders, alter egos, and Berserkers that can work for this stuff. So again, I don't think this will be too hard, and we're still early enough in the nodes that the health values of the ending unit have not reached such a high amount that it's going to be, you know, too prohibitive for a lot of people. So we're going to be able to get away with a lot of NP1s here and a lot of 6C comps thanks to the nature of this Lotto. But again, due to this, this is probably going to be a node that we are not going to spend too long on, because again, these nodes and the way they're laid out at Christmas are just very quick, sort of one and done each day type of setups. You guys are going to use this to maybe clear your way through and clear this portion of the shop and then move on. Now, this node in particular is going to use our silver portion of the shop. So again, you guys should be able to kind of knock that one out here. But remember, there will be other nodes that will also give silver as part of the like sort of backup material on them. Again, the whole goal is just going to be that you guys want to get this portion of the shop done before we actually get to the Lotto node at the end, so that you guys can just spend the rest of your time farming that out. But overall, there's a couple assumptions we're going to make here. And one is, again, that this is early enough in the event that we're not necessarily going to assume that everybody has MLB on everything. You guys will see, I'll talk about that when we get to it, that some of the comps here are going to basically have MLB drop CE listed in there. But we're going to say that you guys can do it with any 50% CE, because we actually calculated it with zero attack power. So that's going to be kind of one of the assumptions that we're going to make just to make it easier on you. We've also, due to the append system coming up here, tried to keep lores in mind, and so we're not going to go too heavily into them. You might see some Paracelsuses where we maybe tried to shave it down to rank 9 skills and stuff like that. But overall, again, we tried to do the best we can with the skill levels for you guys, because we understand you guys don't necessarily want to have to take everything to 10 if you don't have to. So, all right, let's go ahead and jump right in and show you guys the node. So to begin with here, our node, as you guys can see for the casters, is going to be our standard 333 layout. You guys aren't going to have to worry about too much. Only Edison's really going to be a hurdle, and he's going to be here at 118k. A lot of you guys should be easily able to overcome that with a significant amount of buffs. But as always, we're going to be concerned with trying to do 6 CE comps. Our first comp here is going to be Achilles. And I talked to you guys about the fact that in a lot of cases, we might be able to substitute an MLB drop CE for any 50% CE. That is not the case with Achilles. Achilles has really weird refund in the Scotty system and often ends up needing some form of help. And so if you guys remember that MLB drop CE actually has 10% quick up and 10% NP gain. And Achilles really needs that. As you guys can see, coming off the back end of wave 2, he's only gonna generate 49%, which is the base value. It's the minimal value that you guys would need in order to be able to loop with him. Be very careful with that. For a lot of these comps, you might be able to get away with it, but with Achilles, not at all. If you had an NP2 Achilles, you might be able to make this work. It might be just fine, but there's no health remaining for any of the Achilles comps here at NP1. Having higher NP levels is just gonna make it easier. Certainly, this is gonna work for a lot of you guys. It should make it pretty nice with regards to 6 CE comps, and Achilles is popping a lot of the buffs there on turn 1 and just going. So that's going to be the nice part about this comp. It should be pretty easy as long as you guys have Scotty. And remember, Scotty is going to have a banner just before this Lotto in the download campaign sometime around Thanksgiving there. When you get that opportunity, make sure if you're trying to do a quick comp that you actually do pull Scotty. It's really going to help you out. And even if you aren't trying to do quick comps, Scotty can be a really nice unit to have because of that 50% charge. If you guys want to see a video on that, I did one earlier. Again, I would strongly advise you guys to at least consider picking up a Scotty if you haven't already. So for party composition purposes, we're going to start out with a front line of Scotty, Achilles, and Waver, and then a back line, the other Scotty. So on turn 1 here, you guys are going to want to go ahead and use all of Waver's skills on Achilles. From there, go ahead and plug suit that Waver out and bring in the other Scotty. Use both the Scotty's first skills on Achilles, and then go ahead and use Achilles's skill 1. That should get him up to 100% charge and get all the stuff he needs popped. So go ahead and NP and handle that first wave easy. So now in wave 2, Achilles should have refunded over 30%. Pop Achilles' third skill, and then go ahead and use one of the Scotty skill 2s and skill 3 on Achilles. And then you guys should be good now to go ahead and NP the Bicorn. And thanks to that skill 2 from Scotty, you should refund about 50%, which is exactly the value we're looking at. Now in wave 3 here, go ahead and use the last remaining Scotty, defense down and charge on Achilles. Go ahead and use your plug suit attack buff if you need it, and boom, there you go, you should be fine. Alright, now next up guys, we have a 6CE Astolfo comp, and this one's a little fucky, so just bear with me. Astolfo is damage bonus in this event because this is technically Astolfo's Christmas, even though I refuse to admit it. So basically this is Nightingale's Christmas instead, but it's going to be a really easy comp for him as we're only going to be requiring NP1. We are having an MLB drop C, but you guys could in theory use anything else as long as he had the damage to kill. We did assume an MLB drop on him though, and then we assumed a normal drop CE on our Arash. He's going to take out wave 1, and that's only going to be at level 1, so we didn't level up the normal drop CE at all. We are going to be requiring Waver and Scotty for this, but we're also going to be using Mage Association to help make up the difference in charge. This comp is very nice in terms of damage output, it just needs a little bit of help on charge. The staggered supports certainly help you. It makes it so that you guys don't necessarily have to go apeshit in terms of support requirements. It means you can have a Waver and take a Scotty, or have a Scotty and take a Waver, and it should work out for you. So this is one reason why we always try to do that, and we tried to tell you, hey, you really only needed the third skill on Waver level, though I think at some points we did slip up and say, you know, 10 10 10 on Waver. As you guys can see, we don't care about refund. This is an Astolfo comp. Astolfo really doesn't generate a whole lot of refund because he's got a one hit and P. Instead, we're more focused on the fact that he can 50% charge. That's what's going to make this so doable, and especially with that damage bonus, it's going to make it really nice. Well, let's talk about the party composition here. You guys are going to want to start out with a front line of Arash, Astolfo, and Waver, and then Scotty on the back line. For turn one here, you guys want to start out by using Arash's third skill to get him 30% charge with a normal drop. That's going to bring him up to 60%. Then from there, you guys are going to go ahead and use the Mage's Association charge on Arash. That's going to get him to 80%. Then go ahead and use all of Waver skills on Astolfo. That should also overflow 20% to Arash and allow him to NP. He'll easily handle the first wave, die, and rotate Scotty in. Now here in turn two, Scotty has come in, so you guys can go ahead and utilize Scotty's first skill on Astolfo and then just fire off that NP, and it should be really nice. Now on turn three here, you guys can go ahead and use Scotty's second skill for the defense down, Scotty's third skill to charge Astolfo, and then go ahead and use Astolfo's first and third skills to get him the charge that he needs, as well as the attack up that he'll also need, and just go ahead and fire off the NP. If for some reason you were somehow lowballing it, you do still have Mage Association to shuffle the cards, so it does give you some options. Right now, guys, we're going to have our 6CE Marie Rider comp. We didn't forget it this time like we did at Gilfest, so it is in here, and we're actually going to have another comp for you guys as well. But this one's a very easy comp as always, because you guys can see we only are going to require NP1 for Marie, and then also we're going to have 111 skills all the way across the board on Marie, as she really doesn't require any investment to loop. Marie's issue is never her ability to loop, it's more her ability to do enough damage to loop, so as long as we have enough damage, we should be okay. But you guys can see here, with an NP1 Marie, Edison will live, so that is going to be our stumbling block here, approximately 30% of the time, with at most 7k remaining. That's not going to be bad in a quick comp where we've got stars aplenty. You'll easily be able to handle Edison there. This should be fine, but if you do manage to have a higher NP level of Marie, it probably will turn this into a clean clear every single time, really cutting down on the amount of time you spend in node, so it could be very nice for you in that regard. Probably the biggest barrier to entry of this comp is obviously going to end up being Scotty and Waver. This is going to require you guys to have both your own Scotty and Waver, so you can take a support Scotty. That's going to be the hard requirement there, but otherwise it should be relatively easy. We are requiring an MLB drop C on her, and I'm going to tell you guys right now, just based off the refund numbers that we're seeing here, you probably don't want to skimp too much with regards to the CE. If you don't have an MLB drop C, maybe put something with more charge, or maybe try to get something that at least is going to help facilitate her damage or her refund, just because these refund numbers are not that generous, so you don't want to risk it messing up on you if you low roll on the NP. We do calculate all of our refund numbers with a base minimal low roll on the NP just to help protect you guys from that. So as long as you guys don't lose too much in terms of NP gain or card type up, you should be okay. So we're gonna start out with the front line of Scotty, Marie, and Waver with Scotty on the back line. Now for turn one here, go ahead and use all of Waver skills on Marie. That's gonna charge her up to full, and then plug suit out Waver for the other Scotty already. From there, use both the Scotty skill ones on Marie, and that should get her everything she needs to loop, so fire off that NP and you should be fine. Now in turn two here, go ahead and use one of the Scotty defense downs and her third skill to charge Marie back up to full. Go ahead and NP here and handle that bicorn easily even at NP one. And as we get into turn three here, go ahead and use the last remaining Scotty defense down and charge skill on Marie, and then go ahead and use the plug suit skill one to get her just a little bit more damage output to help her with that Edison, especially if you guys are there at only an NP1 Marie. Again, Edison will only live 30% of the time, so it should be easily doable for a lot of you. Okay, now next up we have a 5 CE comp. This is gonna be one of the only ones in the video. This is maybe here in case you guys manage to have a super scope, but you don't have an MLB drop CE already. How likely that is, I don't know. But again, this is an option. We just kind of wanted to cover it. You guys can probably also make this variant work with some of the other riders as long as you have it, but we just wanted to kind of show this one off. So we're gonna be dealing with Fragment of 2004 and a super scope. For those of you guys that are unaware, a super scope is an MLB K scope leveled all the way up to level 100. And the reason you do that is because not only is it 100% starting charge, but it also gives you a crap ton of attack power. So it really helps out the damage output. And you guys can see just because of this, even though we lost Waver, we're now suddenly not having any health remaining on Edison. Even at an NP1 Marie, this does make it consistent. And that's partially also because we're getting the NP damage out of the Fragment of 2004, so it's really help offsetting that loss of Waver. All of a sudden, that super scope plus that NP damage buff is really helping the scalability of this comp. Our only real concern is going to be the refund coming off of the back of wave one, where if we just have an NP1 Marie, it's going to get to that exact 49% value, so be careful with that. If for some reason it ends up scuffing on you, and it shouldn't because we're pretty confident in our refund calculations, but if for some reason it did, you guys can always try to pre-card one of the enemies just to help make sure that won't happen to you. You should be fine, but if you notice it happening, that's the solution. Just make sure you don't actually kill one of the units, otherwise you won't refund against them. There's nothing too much more to talk about in this comp other than the double Scotty requirement, obviously, which you guys are probably used to. Scotty, however, will be having a banner right before this Lotto, so hopefully you guys grabbed her there if you didn't already have her, and then you should be able to easily find another Scotty on support, since she will have had that banner and a lot of people will now have her. So we're gonna start out with that front line of double Scotty and Marie. For turn one here, you guys are gonna start out by popping both Scotty quick ups on your Marie. At that point, you're good to literally just go ahead and NP with nothing else being added. She's already at full charge, so it should be easy. She's gonna refund about 49% there, so as we enter turn two, you guys are definitely going to want to use Scotty's skill three to charge her back up to full. But then don't forget, use the Mystic Code skill three here to get her that NP gain that she's gonna need to overcome this. And then boom, she'll handle the bicorn very easily as you NP and refund to about 70%. As we end up in turn three here, go ahead and use both Scotty defense downs and go ahead and use the last remaining Scotty charge skill. And then from there, go ahead and use the Mystic Code's first skill on Marie to get her that extra NP damage. And you should be good at this point to NP and easily slaughter Edison with him having no chance of living. Okay, so first up for our arts riders, we're gonna have Surfmo here, and a surprise to no one. Again, Surfmo has been a really good unit down the stretch, even with Da Vinci Rider out now. You guys can see how she still just manages to punch above her weight as a 4-star, where we're only gonna be using NP1 in this comp. It's a shame though that we don't have another banner for Surfmo, because it'd be great to get her hands on more copies or get some people to even be able to get her for the first time. There's really only that MLB summer banner into the future, which has no actual rate ups on it, so it's pretty garbage in that regard. But I think a lot of people would love to get their hands on another copy of Surfmo. Now as we look at the comp here overall, Edison's gonna be our only foil here, with him living about 60% of the time with that most 14 and a half half K of HP. That should be easily handable with this comp. If you manage to have a better surf mo, it could certainly help that clean clear. Also, we did calculate this with the MLB drop CE, but as you guys can see, the refund numbers are nowhere even close to 100%. So you guys could easily drop this down if you manage not to have an MLB to some sort of other 50% starting charge CE. And if you had one that boosted damage output, you would certainly probably help turn this again into a clean clear here. So if you had a better CE to put on or you had surf mo, you can make it work. But otherwise, we did try to do this in a 6 CE setup. Just the CE does not help surf mo that much, because the refund is really not Surfmo's consideration. Otherwise, the only requirements here are gonna be Bride and Tamamo with Fragment of 2004 at rank 10. This might be a little bit stiff for some people, but if you manage to have a Bride or have a Tamamo of your own, there you go, you can take the other remaining one. And certainly if you have both of them, you guys can take your own Surfmo with an MLB CE on for that day. People will certainly be going through each of the days and shifting their MLB CEs around depending on what the relevant classes are. So you probably can find a nice surf mode to help you in that regard. So we're gonna start out with a front line of Bride and Tamamo and then surf mode. And what's gonna make this comp really nice, we're basically just gonna use everything turn one. You guys can use Surfmo's first skill and third skill, and then Bride, you guys can use the first and second skill on Surfmo, and then Tamamo use the first and third skill on Surfmo, and that should get Surfmo everything that she needs to just go ahead and start that loop going. So go ahead and NP and handle the first wave. As we get to turn two, you guys literally don't need to do anything. She refunded over 100%, so just NP again. And then in turn three, you guys can pop the Fragments of 2004's attack buff here. We did calculate it with that in mind, but if you had a better surf mo, you don't necessarily need to use it. So you guys can go ahead and NP again. Be careful of Edison living with a little bit of health there, and you might have to card it out. Okay guys, now next up here, we're gonna have a Da Vinci comp for Rider Da Vinci. This is gonna be any 50% CE, but of course we calculated it with the MLB drop CE as always. The good thing to remember about Da Vinci too is she doesn't get that much refund from her actual MP. Most of it actually comes from the refund after the NP that's automated, as well as the charge per turn that she gets from her first skill. At least with Da Vinci, we're going to be requiring a 10x10 Da Vinci, but we can make do with only a NP1, which is pretty nice. But you guys can see the Bicorn can sometimes live with a little bit of health here on wave 2, but otherwise not super concerning. The real problem would be Edison in wave 3, but still at 15k, that is an easily handleable amount. And remember guys, if you have a better CE or you have Da Vinci at a higher NP level, you can certainly trim this down and make this so that this is not going to be as big of a thing. Remember guys, there's also another option, and that's that you can level your MLB drop C, but we won't necessarily tell you guys to do that, but you can get a lot of attack power out of that. This is an all attack scaling CE, so it certainly could help out your damage prospects. We will be using Plug Suit in this comp, but we're gonna make do with Waver, Tamamo, and Paracelsus. The other thing that we noticed is if you say had Nero Bride instead of Paracelsus, it actually does make this comp clean even at NP1, so you don't have to worry too much about it in that regard. We did manage to make do with Paracelsus only at rank 9 skills here. He's not even going to take out a wave for us. We're just going to use Da Vinci the whole way, but it does actually give you guys a more free-to-play option for you in case you don't have a Bride. That way, maybe you have Waver, maybe you have Paracelsus and you find the Tamamo, maybe you have Tamamo and Paracelsus and you find the Waver, or maybe you have all three and you find the Da Vinci. So we tried to make this as malleable as possible so that it could work for as many people as possible. For the party composition, we want to start out with Paracelsus, Da Vinci Rider, Waver, and then Tamamo. On turn one, we're going to start out by using all of Waver's skills on Da Vinci. That should get her charged up to full. Go ahead and plug suit out that Waver for Tamamo. Use Tamamo's first and third skill on Da Vinci Rider, and that should get her a little bit more damage. And then go ahead and use Paracelsus's second skill as well as third skill on Da Vinci, and that gets her the refund she's gonna need. Then you guys are gonna wanna go ahead and pop Da Vinci's first skill. That's her charge per turn that she's gonna need. From that point, go ahead and NP with Da Vinci and you should be good, easily handling the first wave, refunding to about 60%, but then she'll get 40% charge after her NP from her skills and her forced refund. Now in turn two here, she's at 100% charge. Just go ahead and NP with Da Vinci and you should easily handle everything with maybe the Bicorn living some of the time. And then in turn three now, go ahead and use Da Vinci's third skill, that should get her the charge that she needs to make up that little bit of difference there from turn two. And then go ahead and use the plug suit attack buff, and you should be fine to NP one last time, handling Edison. Also, at this point, it's worth noting Paracelsus has been charged to full, so you can NP with him after the fact if for some reason you would need to. Okay guys, next up we actually have a Kiara comp. This is going to be Alter Egos for us. So remember guys, Alter Egos deal 1.5 times damage instead of 2.0 damage because they're not effective. They're just only semi-effective. This is going to be using any 50% CE. Obviously you guys can turn this into 6 CE if you guys manage to have what you need. So this could end up being MLB CE right here on Kiara, and then maybe a non-MLB on Paracelsus if you don't manage to have double MLB. Probably one of the big barriers to entry is we are going to be requiring NP2 Kiara for this. You guys could certainly brute force loop Kiara, but that's probably looking more at a 5 CE comp if you do that. And then we are going to be using Plug Suit, Tamamo, and Waver alongside. The good news here is Paracelsus is going to be taking out one of the waves himself here at the beginning, and because his third skill is not needed to make Kiara loop, we will be using it on her, but we don't have to require it be at any level. So the only requirement is going to be rank 9 on Paracelsus, and a lot of that is going to happen because he needs the damage in order to actually be able to handle the first wave there. But yes, also that rank 9 will come in handy for Kiara. As you guys can see, we have that bare minimal 49% there. Otherwise, the only concern that we're going to have is here on the back end with Edison living 13% of the time with 3.4k remaining. That's not bad. Whenever you guys see any percent here, it just means we calculated with no attack value on the CE, so anything that you could use that would enhance Kiara's damage or loop ability would help this out even more, and you might even be able to get away with a lesser NP value, though probably not. So just keep that one in the back of your head. We're gonna go ahead and start out with a front line of Paracelsus, Kiara, Tamamo, and then Waver on the back end. For turn one now, you guys are gonna wanna go ahead and start out by using the Tamamo first and third skill on Kiara, and then go ahead and plug suit out that Tamamo for Waver. As Waver comes in, go ahead and use all of the Waver skills on Kiara to bring her up to full, and then give Paracelsus a little bit of charge. And then from there, go ahead and use Paracelsus's first, second, and third skills, but you want the third skill to be used on Kiara. So from there, you should be okay to NP with Paracelsus. He'll handle wave one, and you don't have to worry too much about anything then. Now in turn two, Kiara's already fully prepped, so go ahead and fire off her NP, and she should handle the Bicorn here in NP2 fairly easily. Now in turn three here, go ahead and utilize Kiara's first and second skills that she's gonna need for damage output and charge, and then go ahead and use the plug suit attack buff and fire off that NP one last time. Edison should be easily handleable with maybe 13% of the time he lives. Okay guys, here we go. Here's gonna be our first buster comp of the node. This one's gonna be using Drake, which is an obvious solution to a lot of caster nodes out there because Drake has that nice 50% charge. Good news is we're only requiring NP1. The bad news is it gets a little spicy here on wave two, and that's just gonna be because we're actually using Annie Blonde. We're using double waver here to make the charge work. Realistically speaking, Drake there at full charge on turn two is not going to have a whole lot of buffs to help out in terms of damage output. The good news is we're going to use a rash to handle wave one, and you guys can see there he should be easily capable of handling wave one in terms of damage output, but we are looking at double MLB drop CE here. You guys could certainly use something like aerial drive in place of an MLB drop CE. It would help out the damage even more in Drake's case, but that would be dropping down to 5 CE instead of 6, so I will leave that choice up to you and your own circumstances. So we're going to start out with a front line of rash, Drake, Waver, and then Waver on the back line. For turn one here, go ahead and use a Rash's skill 3 to get him to 80% charge, and use one Waver's skill 2 and 3 to bring a Rash to full and fire off that NP. At that point, a Rash should easily handle wave 1, and you'll end up in wave 2 with Waver having been rotated in. So now in turn 2 here, we've got both the Wavers, so use the remaining Waver's skill 1 there on Drake to get Drake to full charge, and then go ahead and use the Mystic Code skill 2, the Star Bomb here, to help you out in case you need it, and fire off the NP with Drake, and easily handle the wave with only the Bicorn living and maybe having to be carted out. Now here on turn 3, go ahead and use all of the remaining waiver skills on Drake. Use Drake's first and third skill here to give her the damage and charge her up to full, and then use Annie Blonde's Buster Up on Drake as well to get her the damage that she's going to need to clear Edison. Fire off that NP, Edison should only live 35% of the time with at most 8.5k remaining HP, easily handleable for someone like Drake. All right, next up here, we actually have a 6CE comp with Santa Alter. So if you guys aren't familiar, Santa Alter is a year one welfare. She is very powerful, very strong, and we used it to demonstrate the fact that this is a 0% charge comp for our riders here. Obviously, a lot of people are not going to have her, but we managed to make it work with no skill requirement on her because the damage is just pretty insane. So even at 111 skills, your Santa Alter at NP5 would be able to handle this pretty easily. But this will also work for an NP1 Iskandar or an NP2 Ivan. And you might be able to make it work for other riders too if you have an exceptional version of them. We just didn't do the calcs on that. The big problem for this one is going to be one, having two MLB drop CEs, but again, you guys can step down to 5 CE and replace this with something like an Aerial Drive or Holy Night Supper or Suzukathai CE even, anything that would help out damage and has 50% starting charge. But the other real big barrier to entry here is going to be double waiver Scotty. We require three 50% chargers to make this work, particularly double waiver for that sort of overflow charge that'll help out a rash. Yes, this can cause some issues as people might not necessarily be able to have all the components of this. You're going to need your own waiver and your own Scotty. You might be able to substitute a second Scotty in place of the second waiver, but just understand what that's going to do to your damage output in some cases. So should be relatively straightforward, but it's probably going to be a decent amount of button presses, especially considering we're working with a rash and a plug suit. That's going to be a whole lot of time spent in the comp rotating things around and trying to charge people to full. But otherwise, this should work for just about everybody if your only concern is 6CE. All right, so for our party composition here, you guys can start out with a rash, Santa Alter or your 0% rider, waiver, and then waiver and Scotty in the back line. Realistically, it doesn't matter as long as you have one of the waivers in the front line. Now for turn one here, you guys are going to go ahead and start out by popping a rash's third skill to get him 30% charge up to 80%. Go ahead and use the waiver's second and third skills to charge a rash to full, and then if you want, go ahead and use that waiver skill one on Santa Alter there to bring her to full as well. From here, go ahead and fire off a rash's MP and he should handle the first wave easily, rotating in the other 50% charger there in the back. Now from here on turn two, you actually don't have to do anything. You guys can just NP, but if you have a multi-turn duration buff on a 0% rider, maybe that's what you go with here in turn two to help damage output. Now in turn three, you guys can go ahead and use the last remaining waivers skills all on Santa Alter. Rotate one of the waivers out, bring in Scotty, use her charge to charge Santa Alter to full, use her defense down in this wave, and then pop that plug suit attack buff should you need it. And there you go, easily able to handle the wave and Edison cleanly with an NP5 Santa Alter, or again, like we said, NP1 Iskandar, NP2 Ivan. Okay, last but certainly not least here for the Buster comps, we're going to have Okitan. And Okitan is going to require NP2 for this one to work. You might be able to step it down to NP1 if you had a better damage CE than the MLB drop CE, but obviously drops are the most efficient thing you can take, so that's what we did the calculations based off of. But certainly here at NP2, you'll see Edison manages to live about 15% of the time. Now it's only going to be 4k remaining at most, so not too bad there in terms of that health requirement. But like I said, if you're trying to stretch it with an NP1 Okitan, you might be able to do it. Just be careful about how you're trying to do it, and maybe make sure that you can stretch it somehow, either by taking a better CE or leveling the CE up. The cool part about this comp is we have staggered support, so you guys are going to be able to use Merlin, Waver, and Scotty here, but it is going to allow you to take the one that you're missing. So if you have Waver and you have Scotty, you can find a Merlin. If you have Merlin and you have Scotty, you can find a Waver. If you have Merlin and Waver, you can find a Scotty. This will help you guys out in that regard. We are going to be using a rash to handle wave one, so nothing too crazy there, but otherwise this should have the damage that we need in order to be able to handle it. But it is going to be again in a rash and plug suit comp, so a lot of party rotation here. So we want to start out here with a front line of Arash, Okitan, Merlin, and then Waver and Scotty on the back end. The reason we're starting out with Merlin here again is just going to be that this is going to help Okitan the most possible for wave two. And that's going to be our concern, is just to make sure that she gets over that hurdle where she doesn't have a lot of buffs. So in turn one right here, you guys are going to want to start out by using Arash's skill 3 and then Merlin's skill 1. That's going to charge Arash to full, have him go ahead and fire off the NP, rotate the party for the Waver in the back line, and end up in wave 2 here. So now in wave 2, go ahead and use Merlin's skill 3 on Okitan, and use Okitan's skill 1 and skill 2 to get her the charge and the damage she's going to need. Then go ahead and use the Mystic Code's attack buff on this wave. That should help her out with damage, and boom, there you go, she's going to NP, handle the Bicorn pretty cleanly, which she's kind of tight on, and you should be okay. And now for turn 3, we're going to go ahead and pop Okitan's skill 3. Go ahead and use the Waver skills all on Okitan, and then plug suit out either Merlin or Waver, whoever you so choose, for the other 50% charger in the back line. Use all of their skills to charge Okitan to full, and then if it's a Scotty, use the defense down, and then go ahead and fire off that NP, and you should be fine here on Edison, easily able to handle it as long as you had that NP to Okitan. Okay guys, that's gonna be it for the caster node here. Again, I hope this video managed to give you guys some solutions, or at least something to think about, or maybe you guys can craft your own for this. Again, there's also gonna be the universal comp video, so if you guys don't have anything here that works, maybe you guys have something there that can help you. But again, don't forget there's damage bonus units here, so you guys can always try to make something kind of work there with that, even if you maybe can't do a 6 CE comp or something. But hope to see you guys for the next one. I believe that'll be the Saber node after this. And then again, guys, as always, I stream weeknights on Twitch at 7 p.m. Eastern, always FGO. And then you guys can also come join the Discord or follow me on Twitter if you guys want to help keep in touch, or just look for a community to help you maybe get some friends on your friends list that you actually know, maybe read some guides, who knows. But I will see you guys for the next video. Have a good one and happy hunting.